So when I started in the videography space about a couple of years ago, one of the first things I picked up, maybe other than a camera and a lens, was a tripod. I decided to go with the Manfrotto Compact Action Tripod, really for a couple of reasons. I had a couple of friends in the videography and photography space that already own Manfrotto gear, and they thus recommended them as a good option to consider. Now for a quick rundown of the specs of the tripod, it is made of aluminum, so even for its size and overall build, pretty decently sturdy. Weighs about 2.5 pounds in and of itself. Has flip locks, which I do find to be a plus over, say, twist locks or other alternatives. Has a minimum height of around 17 inches or so, and can max out at around a little over 5 feet, say 61 inches. Does come with a quick release plate, though not the Manfrotto 200PL plate that I now use on other tripods and monopods and things of that nature from Manfrotto. It does also have a multi-purpose ball-like head for photo and video, so it will let you shoot in a vertical mode, say if you wanted to position your camera in that way, and will also let you do quasi pans and tilts, though I'll talk about that more. And it does have a quick convenient knob that will let you adjust the positioning of the head as well. Also worth noting, the tripod does come with one of the better bags I've seen ever included with any tripod or monopod, and that includes many more expensive models I've now come across doing this and buying more things as time has gone on. Now, not all products are perfect, and I would say this is the case of the Compact Action Tripod as well. So, what are some things I'm not particularly thrilled about? I would say, first and foremost, these aren't necessarily faults of the product itself, they're really just a function of the price point it sits in, and the fact that you're only going to get so much with the $70 tripod. Number one, this tripod does have a weight limit of around 3.3 pounds. So while it'll handle devices like smartphones with Manfrotto's smartphone adapter, a small point-and-shoot with an integrated lens like Sony's ZV-1, or even APS-C smaller interchangeable lens cameras like my old A6500, it starts to top out at the range of cameras like my A7S III and my A7 III, not so much with smaller prime lenses, but certainly once you get into larger, heavier zooms, or if you're the type of person that kits a camera out with a cage and other things, this tripod really can't handle that amount of weight. And you'll notice at that point the head really not being able to stay in a fixed position and not handle that weight distribution quite well. The second point is really that this head isn't totally designed for videography. It is not a fluid head, so when I mentioned pans and tilts not being quite smooth, they're not. This is really a tripod meant to be left in a fixed position, and it will do that job quite well, but if you're trying to do pans and tilts with it, believe me, I've tried. Not the cleanest thing, and not something I'd recommend. The other thing I would say, again, even though it's an aluminum build, it is a relatively lightweight tripod at 2.5 pounds. So again, if you do have a lot of expensive gear you're planning to leave on it, this is not going to be the sturdiest thing in terms of if someone were to accidentally knock into it, or you were to have a large wind gust come through. I would put better faith in other heavier tripods that are just built to hold larger payloads. So, would I recommend this tripod? Yes, I would. I think you do have to keep in mind who and what this tripod is designed for, though, right? This is a tripod that does excel very well in a travel tripod type scenario, in something to have as a backup or a backup of a backup. I still use mine in and around the house today when shooting different things, whether if I'm streaming or doing a talking head for something or shooting B-roll. It's really a tripod that's going to be designed for smartphones, for smaller integrated lens cameras like the ZV-1, cameras like my old A6500 that are a bit on the smaller side, like Sony's APS-C bodies. Once you're into the territory of using larger cameras, lenses, or if you kit your camera out with different things, you're essentially at the point of exceeding the tripod's weight limit, and you probably want to look elsewhere. And as I also mentioned, you have to keep in mind the fact that this is not a true fluid head tripod. It is not going to give you smooth pans or smooth tilts. Though again, you're not going to get all of those features for a tripod that sits at around $70. So some things to keep in mind in terms of a quick review on the Compact Action Tripod. I've been really happy with it, and even though I've sort of upgraded and moved on to other tripods over time, say the Manfrotto 290 Extra Series legs with the 128 RC head, which I'll probably do a review on at some point, this has remained a really good backup that I keep around the house with me, and I will even throw in my bag for gigs as a just in case. Certainly considering that I didn't even know what I would get with this tripod when I first got it, and that my cameras and kits have gotten larger and changed since I've gotten it, the fact that I'm still able to keep it around and use it today shows that it's a tripod that really does go above what it offers in its price range and does punch above its weight class, so to speak. So hopefully this little quick review has been of some help to you. If Feel free to leave a like and subscribe if it has. I'm definitely planning on doing more gear reviews as time goes on with different things I've purchased and have some experience using. That is all I have to say, so thanks for watching.